I wanted to try to explain what we're trying to build here.
Okay, so these are the parts that we're building today. We have this pivot thing that pivots around the plastic bushing on a silver steel shaft. And then we have this adjustable gray part here, and that's the part where the programming pins are gonna hit the registrator, and we can adjust the timing of the whole machine on this part. Then we have the connecting arm that will fall down when it's muted, and the connecting arm connects to the marble gate. And this is the new version of a marble gate that is a huge improvement from the first machine, and that's the 3D printed part.
So this is the test for the skin of the programming wheel, and the programming pins is a magnet, and under here we have a thin layer of metal, and we routed these holes on the CNC machine, and these are the 16 notes of the music. So I can put the programming pin in, it snaps in like that, and the magnet is holding it, and I can pull it out. And later this pin is hitting the registrator like this. That's how a note is played. And if we look more closely, this screw is a timing adjustment screw. So if we tighten this, if we loosen these screws and tighten this screw, this piece will shift like this in angle, which will result in the programming pin hitting the registrator later, which will result in that the instrument plays the note later. So this little screw is a screw responsible for making the whole machine playing tight. And we have 38 channels, so we need to make 38 of this, 38 of this, 38 of this, 38 of this. And this bolt is a weight nut. It's only put in there to add some weight to the part, because we're gonna use gravity here by letting the piece fall down when it's muted. And we want it to fall down a little bit fast and predictable, so we added the weight nut. So the muting looks something like this. Muted, playing. Muted, playing. Like now it's muted, and now it's playing. Muted, playing. Yeah, so that's basically it. So now we just have to make a lot of pieces. So what are you working on?
I'm making a setup sheet, so I know which tool I should put in there with which cam file I'm gonna put on the CNC machine.
So the machining time of this procedure is right now on 5 hours and 38 minutes.
Then that's only the drilling.
What?
That's only the milling. The drilling comes additional to that weight. Almost 7 hours.
7 hours. Okay. And first of all, we have to secure the plywood to the working table, and then we're gonna start cutting. What we're gonna do now is that we're gonna pick up a timing belt from an industry place, and we ordered this custom built for the Marble Machine X, and we're also gonna buy some screws. And I just wanted to film this because this is a big part of what we do, what we work with. We do this
all the time. So there's a lot of time going into supplying material and supplying screws and supplying gears. So I'm really excited to see those metal gears, because on the first machine I built them by myself from wood and they were not good. So let's see if these are better. So these are the gears we ordered. Oh wow. So this is a timing belt. It's like a belt with gear teeth. Wow. So this is the diameter for our shafts, and that's the keyway. This is the little one. So this one is going to be on the crank axis, and this one is on the sun gear axis up there.
Custom made parts.
Yeah, I'm very happy. I made from the first machine, I made these from wood.
Yeah.
And they were actually having big problems because they were skipping a teeth. So the gear would climb up.
Yeah.
And all of a sudden, like the belt,
it
made like one jump. And actually marbles were shaking and falling off the machine.
Yeah.
And this is never gonna do that. This will stay on. And I think this will be really silent also.
Yeah.
And I would never be able to rip it apart, right?
I don't think so.
No. So this place have the best assortment of screws I have ever seen. It's like a library with only screws. So no matter which screw Marius have asked me to get, I can just go here and they have it. It's absolutely amazing. And it's like, it's not like the usual wood screws that you have at your Home Depot. It's like only like industrial machine screws. So we're getting a screw that fits here. This is a very Matthias Wandel kind of solution where the screw will pinch the bushing and you can adjust the play on the axis with this screw. So we're buying this screw and some washers now. And this is like screw Christmas Eve registrators. So and this marble divider. Oh, here we have short screws for registrators. I think that can be in the same box. Registrators weight nuts. These screws go together with these nuts.
Oh yeah.
So we have threaded inserts for the registrators.
Mm-hmm.
Adjusting screw for the registrators. This is programming wheel, two sizes.
Mm-hmm.
So these are also programming wheel, two sizes. Programming wheel. They can go in the same box as the screws.
Mm-hmm.
All this is marble divider. So this is for the adjusting screws mm-hmm. of the marble divider. And this is for the marble divider.
Okay.
So we're actually building this in a part of Sweden called Trollywood. It's like a film center of Sweden. First there was Hollywood, then they came with Bollywood, and Sweden had to answer with Trollywood. So we're in Trollywood and we had a very special day because today we were celebrating Marius' birthday. So almost the whole MMX team came up to Trollywood. Karin and Olof came from Lund, Lois came from Utrecht, and Marius was there for almost 5 full weeks. So it was great being this many people on a task like this. We could just take a chisel each and start removing the taps that the CNC machine always leaves. So we started getting the parts out, and it went pretty quickly actually. And here is another example of Marius' genius. He made these jigs in Fusion 360 that we routed on the CNC that can hold the parts securely and firmly for some machining operations on the router table. So here I'm hollowing out the middle of these parts, almost creating a kind of fork-like structure. And this will be a very precise and even result. And we also made jigs for the drill press. So you can put the part into this jig and you can drill the hole and have very even results. And Tobias was there in a kind of a way because he sent these marble gates, 3D printed marble gates. We're struggling a little bit with the color and we're trying to find a better color for the filament. And Nathan's engineering soul is ever present in the shape of a gigantic CNC machine, so it felt like we were almost kind of complete. And here we're making another jig. That's a jig to make another routing operation for the pivot pins. And this routing operation was a little bit sketchy. I'm keeping the thing between the router bit and the fence, and the router bit is up way too high, and I'm feeding in the direction that the router bit is going, and I'm making a lot of mistakes, and I had a lot of kickbacks.
It should read 10.5, so I can adjust that by moving the fence a little bit closer. So this was a little bit too much to take away, but that might be okay. So we have, so these pieces go together like that, but we have a little bit too much of a gap here.
I had a lot of problems with this operation, and I think there is much better and much safer way of doing this. So don't do it like this. You can kind of see on my body language here that I'm not really comfortable.
So this turned out too tight, so we have to move the fence.
When you're not comfortable, rethink and redo. Safety first. So this is cool. You make one side and then you flip it over to the other side. And the other side is supported, and then you can route that side. And that will leave us with a cool middle part that fits into the fork that we made earlier. This screw is called Boston screw. I think Tobias taught us that. And that's the parts completed. Here we started the assembly of the upper frame that will be on the very top of the Marble Machine X. And that includes all our 158 new plywood parts for the registrators. But this will be material for an upcoming Wintergatan Wednesday video. If there would be like a fight between the registrators of the first marble machine and the registrators of the Marble Machine X that we're building in this video, the registrators of the MMX would eat the registrators of the first machine for breakfast. So yeah. It's a universe between them in functionality, and it's improvements like this that makes me totally confident in that we will succeed of building a marble machine that I can take on a world tour to play live in front of all of you. So that is the goal that we're constantly working towards, literally like one part at a time. So well, we're 158 parts closer after this episode. Thanks so much for watching, and thanks so much to the MMX team for being there to help out. Okay, take care, see you next week.